Hello. Good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. Today's tutorial, very simple one. Advanced inventory management tricks and tips and advanced control panel management tricks and tips. To get started, I'm going to go into my cargo container on my creative mode save by opening it using the inventory button, and I wanted to show you a couple of things that you may or you may not know. Let's start with one of the first simple ones, in that I have a full inventory. I don't have to spend time pressing A on all of these to take them back over to my small cargo container. All I need to do is just press the inventory button again, and all of my components are deposited into the cargo container I've been interacting with. That's one useful trick. There's also another. You're familiar with pressing A to fetch objects in and out, like this. But there is a hidden function on the Xbox One controller that's not mentioned. If you hold down A, you will open the stack window. And with this stack window, you can choose the amount you want to take into a container or pull out into your inventory. So say we wanted to split these 36 in any way. One of the quick ways with a large amount of objects and to hold down both bumpers, and you'll notice when you press left on the D-pad it will take it almost close to the center. So if you press right again and then press X, you'll see we've split these 18 to 18. Now if I want to recombine that stack either in my cargo container or my inventory, all I have to do is press A on either of those and the stack will recombine like this. Let's split the stack again though. You can split it however you want. Now let's say for some strange reason we have two stacks in our inventory. To recombine them, well, we could put them back in the cargo container and they would recombine, or you can hold the right bumper and press left on the D-pad to move one stack into another. So let's put these back into our cargo container, barring one. Or rather, let's put one into the cargo container and leave 35 in our inventory. This way you can choose only the components you want. So if you only need 5 bulletproof glass, you leave 5 in there, pull out 1,000, or whatever you want to do to split the stack down the middle. And manage your inventory. Basically, this should save you a lot of time when you need to pick up only 10 plates or whatever from your inventory. Like so. That's part one of this. Part two is the control panel. I've seen people talking about how the bumpers work, and someone on the YouTube channel mentioned that they had problems with their left bumper. Well, this video is for you. let's look at my atmospheric thrusters. I'm going to talk about atmospheric thrusters as well, and any thrusters, ion, hydrogen, very briefly before I actually go into how to use the bumpers effectively to select objects you want to group. And I'll recap how to group as well for those people who may not have seen my first ever video. I wanted to point out a thing that can happen with thrusters, especially if you break the golden rule of navigating windows. So let's talk about the golden rule. This is the main window. All of this, with all the things you can see. The three windows in front, grid blocks, toggle block, show blocking terminal, all that, those three separate windows are sub-windows. And if you want to get from a window to a window, do not use the D-pad. Use the left stick. Left stick will take you from window to window, and it will not interact with anything else. You can flick around like this with the left stick quite quickly to get where you want to be to do what you want to do. Now, let's just say that I have a spaceship and I would like to make some adjustments, or I'm flicking through my list. So I'm going down through my atmospheric thrusters and I want to add that atmospheric thruster to a group on its own. If I press right on the D-pad now, you'll see why we use the left stick to navigate windows. Oh, now I've navigated to thrust override, but instead of just navigating to thrust override, I've now set atmospheric thruster 8 at 18.5 newtons. That will no longer respond to your control panel on your ship. You can no longer send commands to that thruster. That thruster will always push out 18.5 newtons. And if that thruster is one of your thrusters, either front, back, up, down, your ship is going to start moving in that direction. If you're wondering why your ship is leaning to the left or the right, maybe it's a thrust override issue. So my advice is never use the D-pad to go from window to window in these sub-windows. Let's set it back by pressing left on the D-pad. As you can see, it's really, really sensitive. You tap right on the D-pad, right on the D-pad, right on the D-pad, and it will go up to 55.5 newtons. Now, if you are making a group and you catch that setting for one or two of your thrusters, you will no longer be able to control those thrusters manually. So let's go back with the left stick into this grid blocks window and use the D-pad. The D-pad is fine to navigate through these sub windows, through these lists. If we go right into this one, you can see if I press up and down on the D-pad, I can navigate all the way through these without too much issue. Hopefully that will help you when you do your own ship designs, especially when it comes to thrusters. Now though, I'm going to talk about the functionality of the left bumper, the right bumper, and both bumpers, because they don't function the same. I've seen people say, oh, I use the right bumper to do all my things. That's well and good if you're going down a list. But if you go up and down with the right bumper, you'll see what happens. So we start with the left. You want to group all your atmospheric thrusters as a group. You hold down the left bumper and you tap down on the D-pad until you reach the end. Whatever you do, do not press right on the D-pad to get to the block group. Push right on the left stick and you'll go straight to the block group. You can navigate straight there just by pushing the left stick through the windows. When you're at the block group, press A, name your block group, don't forget to save. I'll show you. I'm going to name it Thrust. I always like to name my block groups based after the ship they're on, because unique block groups will always have a unique name and they won't be controlled by the same commands. If you've got a particular command on your ship that controls, say, landing gear, and you've got a mothership with a bunch of other ships attached, you will toggle all of those group names, landing gear, on and off. So if you have separate named ships, then name your groups separately as well. Then we hit save, and we don't use the D-pad either. We use the left stick, push it down, go to save, and create a new block group. There you go. Pushing left on the left stick again takes us all the way back over to our window. Now we can safely use the D-pad to flick through the list. So that was the left bumper. To repeat, hold it down, scroll through the list of things you want, let it go. If you press on the D-pad again, you'll deselect the lot. Let's talk right bumper. Right bumper modifies this in a different way. It might look the same when you hold the right bumper down and you go through the list, but watch what happens when you push up on the D-pad. Atmospheric thrust at 8 is selected. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 and 2 are not. Now I've managed to completely deselect everything except atmospheric thrusters 8. The right bumper will let you paint your list, but it will also deselect items within the list above the item that you hold down the right bumper on. So right bumper, atmospheric thrusters, hold it all down, but I only want 8, so let's just leave 8 selected, let go, and you'll see it all deselects again. The moment you let go of a bumper and push the D-pad, you will deselect anything you've selected. So if I wanted to select all of this, I would use the left bumper. Then I would go across to the block group and name it, whatever. So, now, what happens if I only want to select every other thruster? Normally, you'd probably want to name every other thruster a similar name so they'd show up in a search, so you could easily just select them like that. But you can use the bumpers to navigate the list. And it's a bit tricky because of the way that both bumpers, when pressed together, interact with the grid block list. Hold down both bumpers on the atmospheric thruster, press down on the D-pad once, let go of the left bumper and keep the right held, press down on the D-pad again, hold both bumpers, down on the D-pad, let go of the left, keep the right held, down on the D-pad, both bumpers, down on the D-pad, left bumper off, right bumper held, down on the D-pad, both bumpers, down on the D-pad, let go of left, and push down on the D-pad. As you could see, we have every other object there selected, including the small cargo container. The left and right bumpers let you pass over the list without interacting, and when you reach an object you want to select, if you let go of the left bumper, push down on the D-pad and hold the right, the both bumpers again, you will select the object below where you were in your list, like that airtight hangar door is now added. So if I wanted to add airtight hangar door 3 to the list, I would hold down both bumpers on airtight hangar door 2, move down to 3, let go of the left bumper, and then press down on the D-pad. And then you'll notice I have to press up on the D-pad to get back to airtight hangar door. It is a bit tricky to do. Let's deselect all that again. So you can use both bumpers to select something and then move through the list and not bother with anything else in that list. But you will always select both the object that both bumpers are on and the one below it in the list if you hold down the left bumper. Both bumpers, down on the D-pad, hold down the right bumper and let go of the left, you can move down the list. Hold down both bumpers again, push down on the D-pad. You'll have atmospheric thrusters 3 selected. Let go of the left bumper but keep the right held and you'll be able to get down to atmospheric thrusters 5 without selecting 4. Hold down both bumpers and push up on the D-pad, let go of the left bumper and push up again, you'll be able to move to atmospheric thrusters 3 without selecting atmospheric thrusters 4. It takes some getting used to, but you can actually select objects within a list without needing to interact with any other object. If you remember the rule of the bumpers, left will select everything. Right bumper will select everything but also deselect. Both bumpers will pass over after selecting one object on the list. Hopefully this is of some use. Also, if you want to speed your list up, there is an option called toggle show in terminal. Let's select all of my atmospheric thrusters and press Y. They're not gone, they're hidden. If you want to get them back, use the left stick to get to show hidden blocks. Press A and everything you've hidden from your grid will reappear so you can see it. Press A again and it will be hidden. You'll see that no matter, even if you search, you have to unhide the blocks for them to turn up in the grid block list. As I said, hopefully that has been useful, informative. It'll give you some idea, help you with your builds, help you navigate the inventory better, speed things up, help you group objects so you can do things like have these airtight hangar doors open and close on a button panel press. If you don't know how to do that and you're new, take a look at my first ever video on Space Engineers on this channel, and hopefully that will help you get to grips with that functionality. There we go, that's it. Take care, stay safe, have fun, happy engineering. Until the next one, there will be more. And eventually there will be my automated ice carrying drone tutorial. Bye for now.